How did we meet Energy Star requirements with only 6 inches of roof insulation? Let's find out today on Smith House. Howdy, y'all. It's Jordan Smith. I'm a design builder with Smith House Company, where we believe homes should be built beautifully, functionally, resilient, and with the health of the occupants in mind. Today, we're going to talk about roof insulation and how we got by with only 6 inches of insulation on our Monarch Woods build. Before we get into that design, I want to talk a little bit just about insulation in general. Insulation is measured by an R value, unless you're over in Europe, and then it's U value. Those are the same numbers, just backwards, right? So R is the resistance of the material to heat transfer through it. So the more R's you have, the more resistant to heat flow that material is. U values are the inverse. It's the conductivity of the material. So if you see a U value, that's how easily heat moves through. So if we're trying to stop the flow of energy, we want a high R value and a low U value. Make sense? All right. So when we design a ventilated attic like this guy here for Texas, where I'm at, we need to hit an R38 attic. If you get way up north, you might be an R60. So you're putting in just a whole lot of insulation up there on the ceiling. I don't really like this design because you have to air seal to your ceiling if you do a ventilated attic. And you know my opinions on that. If you punch holes in the ceiling, you punch holes in your air barrier, not good. Whether you do it now when you're building the house or somebody does it 25 years from now when they're remodeling the house. The other thing I don't really like about this is, yeah, you may have to hit an R38, meaning you have to have a certain thickness of whatever insulation material that you're using, but you can't put that full R38 everywhere. You have things like attic door hatches here. You've got your furnace sitting there where people will usually just insulate underneath on the ceiling joist. They won't necessarily lift the furnace up to get that full R38. And then you also have to put less insulation over here at your eaves because it rakes down to let that ventilation come out over the top, and you have less insulation over there, which is okay. The code allows for that. There's some rules saying that, hey, if you have to get under your minimum ceiling insulation, you can go down to R30, but it has to be less than 500 square feet. And don't take my word for it. Go look the code up and you can see exactly what the requirements are. But the reason why they make you go to R38 is because they know that if you're insulating the ceiling, it's not a very efficient insulation method. You have things like framing members coming through that insulation, which is conducting the heat. You have your attic hatches that are not as well insulated. You have a lot of these places with less insulation, and it's not as well insulated. So to make up for that, they add insulation everywhere else up to that R38, so that on the average, if you do everything else right, you're going to have a pretty good insulated ceiling. It won't be, if you actually could measure the whole assembly, it wouldn't be close to R38. And the more holes you create in your insulation, the faster that insulation value for the assembly drops. So let's contrast that with what we did over here at Monarch Woods. So this is a single pitch roof where all of the insulation is on the exterior of the roof deck. And by code, I'm required in Texas to either have R38 in the above the ceiling, or I can have R25 continuous insulation if it is all happening above the decking, and that's exactly what's happening here. Our ceiling in this design is our roof deck, so there's not two planes. It's just the ceiling is the ceiling, and it's what I'm building my roof on top of. In this case, it's this clear dug fir that's sitting on these rafters here, these rafter beams, and then if we look at the top, we did our decking, and then we did, this is just a roofing paper, a tar paper, and then we did two layers of 2.5-inch polyiso. Polyiso is about 6.5, has an R value of about 6.5 per inch. So at 5 inches, we're well above our 25 required. And then we topped it off with a layer of rock wool for a couple of reasons. One, it's more flame resistant than the polyiso. And then two, it was the right thickness and it just looked really cool when the exterior of the walls were wrapped in rock wool and the top was covered in rock wool. It was just this little green building. And then on top of that, we did our plywood and we shot our screws through the plywood, through the rock wool, through the poly, through the tar paper into the decking below. The length of those screws was really important because if they were too long, you'd shoot through the deck and you would see them from the inside. We don't want to do that. If they're too short, they're not engaging with the decking. So we had to make sure that we got the right length of screw. And then on top of the plywood, we did our Tesla WRB. It's a really high quality WRB. I believe it's made by Carlisle, and then they put their Carlisle puts Tesla's logo and a textured surface, which I really like. If my industry sources are true and this is really made by Carlisle, start making it with the texture just to sell to the public, because the Tesla texture is really nice, especially when you're walking around on steep roofs. And then on top of the WRB, or the underlayment, the Tesla pill and stick underlayment, we have our Tesla solar roof. And what I really like about the Tesla solar roof is we actually have a 2-inch air gap between our pill and stick and the solar shingle. And we have ventilated drip edges, so we've got good airflow all the way through. If you watched my last video, you know that I really like airflow. I like to keep everything nice and dry. I build the perfect wall, so I have an air gap there for drying in the wall. And then this is the perfect roof where I have all the insulation exterior to my framing. So I put the jacket on the right side of the house on the outside. It's keeping the whole thing warm. It prevents condensation because I don't have any cold condensating surfaces inside. It helps me with my air sealing because my air barrier is integral to that polyiso. And then we also have that air gap between the solar tiles and the sheathing below, so we get nice and good drying. We did the same thing over here on the Monarch Room, the exact same detail. And this is sort of cool. This is the entryway to the building, is this cantilevered steel. And you see how this I-beam wraps around, and we wanted that I-beam just to feel like it's floating out there. We have the same Doug fir decking on the bottom, and then we just stacked up the exact same layers: our roofing paper, polyiso, rock wool, plywood, and then TPO in this case. But it's the exact same thickness, exact same insulation factor. The insulation on this is above 35, so we are actually Energy Star, not only here in Texas, but we're Energy Star all the way up into Maine and Alaska. So you could build this exact detail all the way up to Alaska and still hit IECC Energy Star requirements. It's absolutely fantastic. It's a great way of building, especially if you're starting a new build. I really like this detail, and it will probably be my go-to detail even if I go to a gable roof. We can still take that insulation up the walls, over the roof, and back down, and put our insulation all on the outside, making for a much more efficient home. We get rid of all of our thermal bridging, we get rid of condensation, we make it nice and airtight, and we just use very little energy with that design. Thanks so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Like it if you liked it. Comment below if you have any more questions or want to see different videos on different topics. Subscribe if we've earned it. We really appreciate those subscriptions. If you need consultation work, go to smithhouseco.com. Contact us, consultation, and I'll get an email and we'll start talking. Again, thanks so much for watching, guys, and we'll see you next time on Smith House.